Hi friends, in today's session let us see major crops of our Karnataka. We have already now that nearly 61.4% of the people in our Karnataka, they are totally dependent on agriculture. Now let us see what is the meaning of agriculture. The cultivation of a land for raising crops is called as agriculture. Whereas animal husbandry, poultry, beekeeping and sericulture is also included in agriculture. We see in our Karnataka different types of crops are there. Main responsible for this are soil, climate condition, relief features, irrigation facility, tradition of farmers and market. For agricultural produce, the crops of Karnataka have been classified into three types. So first one is the food crop. In the food crops, we see paddy, ragi, maize, pulses, millet. Our second type or our second group is commercial crops. In the commercial crops, we see the sugarcane, cotton, tobacco, mulberry, oilseed, groundnut, sesame, sunflower. Our third type of crop is plantation crop. Coffee, coconut, arkanut, rubber and banana. Those are all the types of crops in our Karnataka. Now let's start. Our main topic is major food crops of our Karnataka. First one is paddy. Paddy is very important food crop of our Karnataka. Rice is a staple food of our Karnataka's people. The paddy is grown nearly 28.2% of the total cultivable land. Irrigation facility, use of chemical fertilizers and high yield hybrid seeds have result to improve in the yield of paddy. Those are all very important to grow paddy. Paddy is a tropical crop. Cultivation of a paddy is require heavy rainfall and high temperature. The area having scanty rainfall, it will needed irrigation facility to growing those paddies. Now let's see which kind of soil has. The cultivation of paddy require level land, fertile clay, early level soil are ideal for the paddy growing for paddy cultivation. Organic measures, leaves of the trees and abundant labor it was required for the cultivation of paddy. Nearly 70% of the paddy is sown during the June and August month and harvested during the November and December month. It is a kharif crop. Where is the irrigation facility is there on that area, we should see. Even in summer season also they can grow paddy on February to June. This is called a rabi food. In the Malnad region, we see that paddy is growing in the broadcasting method and in the plants by transplanting method. Paddy is very much famous in our Karnataka. Paddy is grown in all the districts of Karnataka, the Krishna, Tungabhadra Valley, Kaveri Valley and the coastal district of are the most famous for paddy cultivation. Raichur district stands first position in producing of paddy. Next, Ballari, Shumoga, Daungere, Mysore, Mandya, Koppala, Uttara Kannada, Udupi, Dakshina Kannada and Kalaburgi. The other paddy growing area in our Karnataka are Tumkur, Hasan, Chikmagalur, Kodagu, Belagavi and here the quality of paddy in better irrigation area. Those are all about the paddy cultivation in our Karnataka. Now let's move on towards our another food crops, that is Jawar. The second most important crop in our Karnataka after paddy, until recently the area under the jawar cultivation was more than that of paddy. But in recent years it has decreases. The total area under jawar cultivation is 26% of the cultivable area. In the production of jawar, our Karnataka has ranked second position after Maharashtra. Jawar is a staple food of the people of who are living in North Karnataka. It is main used for the preparing rotis. Jawar plants are used for the cattle fodder in South Karnataka. Jawar is primarily grown for cattle feed. This crop means jawar belong to the grass family. It is a tropical crop. It require moderate rainfall and moderate temperature, mix black and red soil and olive soil, suitable for jowar. It is a rain fed crop and grown by using broadcasting method. It depends on the southwestern monsoon. Jowar is also very much famous in our Karnataka. The growing areas are except for a few districts of South Karnataka. All other districts grown jowar like Vijayapura, Kalaburgi, Bagalkote, Raichur, Belagavi, Bidar, Ballari, Davangere, Koppala, Gadag are the leading producer of jowar. Vijayapura stand first position in producing of jowar in our state. Chitradurga, Shivamogga, Chamrajnagar, Hasan, Tumkur, Mandya districts are also a producer of jowar. Those are all about the cultivation of jowar in our Karnataka. Now we have another major crop of our Karnataka, that is ragi. This is a very nutritious food grain. Very much famous food which are made from ragi. Those are the ragi balls, sprouted flour, millet. Those are the important products which are made from ragi. Now let us move on. In Karnataka, it is the third most important food grains after paddy and jowar. It is a cheap grain. It is also called as a cheap grain. The stalk of ragi plants are used for the fodder for cattle. Ragi can be preserved for many months. Ragi is a tropical crop. It has grown in a high temperature, moderate rainfall, and it is grown in the soil. Red, sandy and loamy soil are suitable for this crop. It can withstand very severe drought. In some places, ragi is grown by using irrigation facility also. Many labors are needed to transplant ragi, pull out and weeds, the harvest and store ragi. It is an important kharif crop. By using irrigation facility, it can also grow even during the summer seasons. Major ragi growing areas, Karnataka stands for first position in growing ragi in our India. However, the using of ragi has reduced. Ragi is grown in 14% of the total cultivable land in our Karnataka. The ragi growing areas is concentrated in the district of southern region. In our southern Karnataka, we see the ragi is growing mainly. The ragi is a traditional crop of old Mysore provinces. Jowar is the main crop in north Karnataka, whereas ragi is a main crop of southern Karnataka. In that major areas where the major districts where this crop was grown, those are Tumkuru is a leading producer of ragi. Then come to the Ramnagar, Bengaluru, rural Hasan, Mandya, Kolar, Chikballapura, Shivamogga, Chikmagalur, Chamrajnagar and Davangere. Those are all the districts where the ragi is grown. Those are all about the major food crops of our Karnataka. In our next video, we see the commercial crops of our Karnataka. If you have any queries related to this topic, you can tell in comment box. Thank you for watching this.